So, how's it going, guys and girls? It's Oakley here, and today with you guys is going to be a quick little vlog. Back in my room now, I'm guessing for the immediate future, probably from now on until next summer. Obviously, I've had the luxury of being able to do vlogs outside when the weather's been nice. At the moment, it's like spitting. It's not like raining, but it's not like dry enough to do a vlog, so I guess we're back here. And it's weird, like, I'm in my room so much, obviously, because it's my room, but it's weird like doing vlogs back in here again, because I kind of get like a sense of nostalgia. Like, the amount of videos I've done here is just crazy. And I was thinking about that earlier, it's absolutely mad. And the amount that you guys may have watched is freaking mad. Like, the mind baffles. But yeah, so anyway.
What baffles?
What was that, for Christ's sake? So anyway, last night I had a really spontaneous night, actually. I went out about 9 o'clock, Insidious had started playing. I was like, oh, what do I do? Decided not to watch that. Went out, socialised, went to the pub, got there, and we had been speaking about going to a music night up in Winkers, which is in Chalford. Not a music night, there was like one set from DJ Luck and MC Neat. And I've seen them like twice before, but I thought, screw it, why not? It's something to do. And it's free before 11, it's not too far away, but it kind of fizzled out, so I didn't think it was going to happen. But I got to the pub and they were like, yeah, we're going to go. So I was like, awesome. And they were like, yeah, can we count you into the taxi? I was like, they were like, it's 12 quid each. I was like, yeah, sure, why not? And immediately after saying that, I regretted it, because they booked it up, and I was like, actually, guys, I don't really think I want to drink. Primarily because I wasn't feeling too well, and I was thinking, and the last couple of nights we've been going to bed early, and I was like, the last thing I want is to be there at like 1 o'clock, and me wanting to go home, and everyone else like, having a great time, me being like that dick who's like, yeah, actually, I want to go. So I decided instead to just to drive, and upon arrival, I've been there once before. I was only in there for about half an hour, because my friend's got into a fight, and they all got kicked out. That's a story for another time. I'll get onto that another time. I don't know, I might have spoken about it before. Let me know in the comments down below if I've ever spoken about that night. If I haven't, that'll be a fucking awesome commentary topic. So yeah, definitely let me know in the comment section down below. So I got there, and you know how like in most clubs, there's like an unreal thirst amongst men. Like everyone knows about it. Like, thirst quenches, the only time you quench your thirst when you actually pull. But it's so hard to pull. Normally in most clubs, all the girls like mesh together and they're like in this fist, and you just can't break them away. Like, you've got to chip at them to get them off like their mates. But in this club, I'm not even joking, it's like the biggest role reversal I've ever seen in my life. I've never seen so many thirsty women before, so many horned up women. It's one girl, but the problem was, it's one of those places where it's hard to tell if they're old enough to be in there, because it's normally quite quiet, so you get the feeling that they maybe let some younger people in, like if they're like sisters' IDs or whatever. There was one girl in there, and I know you see it quite often, but there was one girl who, like, her ass was actually out. It was like she was wearing like a leotard, and her bum was literally out. Really nice ass as well. Jailbait material, but we asked her how old she was, and she was 20. So that was all good. I could have proceeded, but I didn't. So anyway, music night was all good, and they always seem to play the decent songs after, like, around the time we're wanting to leave. It shut at 4 o'clock, and we were leaving at about 3, because that's when their taxi left, and obviously I'm not going to stay there on my own. But before that, they were playing like fucking like Rihanna. I don't even know. It's like, what's my name? And you always get that middle-aged white bloke with like a balding head who like just pops up as soon as like Rihanna comes on. Like, it's his favourite tune, the only song that he knows the words to. Like, pops up from the bar, runs along over, like starts doing his dance before he gets there. Does this little disco dad dance, and as soon as the song's gone, he's gone. He like vanishes for the rest of the night, and nobody knows where he is. Like, just sitting there drinking his like single measure whiskey, who's like on the rocks, just like a mature chap. I don't even know what his game is, but yeah, that happened. There was like three of them, and then they left. They actually got back-to-back Rihanna, so they loved that, and then they left. But yeah, towards the end, this girl that I hadn't seen for it wasn't that busy the other night, she appeared, and I kid you not, guys, she was probably the most attractive woman I've ever seen in my life. Like, and I'm not even joking when I say that. Literally, she was beautiful. Blonde hair, amazing body, amazing eyes. She was absolutely licked, and she looked like she was down. And I was like, yeah, I'm sober, I'm driving, this could work very well for me. However, literally, as these thoughts were going, you know, as you get that thought like process, like, is it possible, like, trying to weigh up, like, if it could actually happen, it just got shot, because her hunk of a boyfriend came over, and I was left pretty disgruntled. However, before that, I just to go back to real, like, capitalize on how thirsty these females were. There wasn't just like, you know, the younger girls, like age 20, I don't know, to freaking like 16, whatever they allow in. There was a vast array of cougars. There was a vast cougar selection on offer. It was like a pick a mix. And this, I was getting, I haven't got a massive ego. I'm not like, this is not being me being like egotistical or big headed or boastful whatsoever. But I was getting eyed up to fuck. She was eye fucking me. I kid you not. I was stone cold sober, as I said. Sober? I was stone cold sober, as I said. So I was there at the bar getting my Red Bull, because that's cool, cool cat I am. And she was there, like, on the other side of the bar with, she must be about 42, sipping her VK. And you know, I'm not going to give you the eyes, because any female viewers would just be, like, weak at the knees as soon as they see my, this is my ego, as soon as my eyes come out. But no, she was giving me the eyes. She was, like, sucking on the straw. Like, you know how, like, it's like she was, like, 10 years old. That's how, like, 10-year-olds hold their straw, like, two hands, like this. And she was, properly going for it. It's like, you don't need to suck your straw that hard. Nobody needs to suck the straw that hard. So she's like proper sucking it, like looking, like not even blinking, like no eye contact going. I'm like looking at her like, this is fucked up. Because she's probably got kids and she wants to bang. I didn't bang her though, obviously, but this vlog's going off a very weird tangent. So I'm going to cut it off right here. So if you guys have enjoyed this video, please do a little bit. I'm going to add something else in. I'm going to go see Riddick tonight as well at 8:45 with Lewis. That's actually absolutely fantastic. Or Dr. Fluff, I'm not entirely sure what alias is going by these days. So let's give my outro a second attempt. If you guys enjoyed this video, please be sure to drop a like rating down below. Don't forget to check me out on Twitter, Instagram, my t-shirt shop link will be in the description down below as well. Subscribe if you're new. I've been Oakley, you've been fantastic. Have a great day and goodbye. Ugh. Feels good. Like cougars.